This is my EJV osce, or external jugular venous cannulation osce. My patient here, Steve, has fully consented to the procedure and has already had an injection of lignocaine to the area to help with this process. This procedure can be quite psychologically discomforting to a patient, as well as high risk in terms of complications, so it should be used as a last resort. Now, I have my goods out for me. As you can see, I have my swab, my alcohol prep pad, my lure, my plug, my tape, some spare sodium chloride for a flush, and my Tegaderm, as well as my sharp spin. Now, my 14 gauge cannula has been attached to a pre-made flush that I made for this purpose using saline. This is just to create a closed circuit, which lowers the risk of pneumothorax, air embolisms, and other such complications associated with this procedure. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to swab the area of the skin that I'm inserting my cannula. Now, I have the patient in a supine position currently, with his head tilted to my right, his left, to give me better access to his jugular vein, which I can see quite clearly here. And I'm happy with. You can also place your patient with their legs up in the air in the Trendelberg position to assist in this. I'm just going to swab the skin now, wiping on the back of my glove so I know when it's dry. Like I said, I have this cannula drawn up already with the syringe attached to it, and my saline, of course, has been drug checked by an off-sider. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead with this. All right, I'm just going to feel a sharp scratch, all right, buddy? It's using 14 gauge bore. You want to enter at a 30 degree angle. You want to go straight into that jugular vein. And what you want to do is you want to make sure that you have entered the vein. And a good way of doing that is to check for drawback, or flashback as it's called. Yeah, I've got a little bit of blood in that needle, so I'm just going to flush that back through. Now I'm going to lower the angle that my catheter is on and continue to insert it into the vein. I'm now going to attach the plastic sleeve. Now that I'm happy with where it's sitting, now I'm going to need to apply pressure and include the vein before I remove this needle, just to prevent any leakage. I do have a swab there just in case. Sharps away in the sharps container. I'm now going to apply the lure plug and then secure it with some tape, just because of the risk of movement in this area is much higher than if you were doing a regular IV cannulation. Alright, so I've got that taped there. I'm now going to flush with the saline just to check for patency on the line. And there's no resistance to that, so I'm quite happy that flushed quite easily. So there's been no swelling, so there's no tissue infiltration from the fluid or anything like that, so I'm now going to secure the IV line with my Tegaderm. You're doing a great job there, Steve. Alright, this is not a standard Tegaderm, but it can be used. So I'm just going to attach this. Try and get it as neat as possible so you don't annoy the nurses at the hospital. Nice, and I'm going to secure this again with a little bit more tape. Like I said, there's a high risk of movement to the cannula in this area, which would be bad, as you can imagine. All right, so I'm just going to secure this with a bigger piece of tape here, and I would document the date and time which I place and the gauge size onto the Tegaderm itself for hospital use. Now, when you attach a giving kit and IV bag to this. What you want to do is you want to drape the line around the patient's ear and tape it, I have a piece of spare tape, to the patient's cheek. That just also helps to ensure that if a patient moves their head suddenly, it doesn't pull on that line and cause any damage to the patient. So yeah, this has been my EGV cannulation, Oski. I hope it was informative.